Former University of Makati Law Dean Rico Quicho says Thursday, March 26, he is drafting a complaint against Senator Coco Pimentel. Pimentel breached containment protocol when he visited the Makati Medical Center with his pregnant wife on March 25, despite being on self-quarantine. Member shopping chain S&R also confirms the senator shopped at their store in BGC Taguig City on March 16. He should have gone on a 14-day self-quarantine from March 14 to March 28 because he was already considered a person under investigation. Meanwhile, House Committee on Appropriations Chairperson Eric Yap tests positive for COVID-19 Wednesday, March 25. He is the first congressman to publicly disclose his test results. Yap was not clear if he was already exhibiting symptoms when his test was taken on March 15. While waiting for his results, Yap says he still attended a number of gatherings with high-ranking government officials, including the House's 17-hour special session on March 23, and a meeting in Malacañang with Congress leaders and cabinet members on March 21. Other officials who attended the March 21 meeting in Malacañang were Senate President Tito Soto, Senators Bongo and Pia Cayetano, House Speaker Alan Cayetano, House Deputy Speaker El Rey Villafuerte, Executive Secretary Salvador Medialdea, Finance Secretary Carlos Dominguez III, Budget Secretary Wendell Avisado, and Interior Secretary Eduardo Año. Because of this, the Presidential Security Group says it will consider filing a case against Yap for failing to disclose important information about his health. Meantime, Senator Sonny Angara announces he is also positive for coronavirus Thursday, March 26. But unlike Yap, Angara says he has not been in contact with the public since taking the test on March 16. Angara is the third senator to become infected with the virus after Senators Juan Miguel Zubiri and Coco Pimentel. Senator Panfilo Lacson says the Department of Health and the Food and Drug Administration must act with urgency to flatten the coronavirus curve in the country. Lacson says the lockdown is obviously working, but that alone is not enough. He says the 125,000 test kits donated by South Korea and China arrived last March 21, but are sitting at the Bureau of Customs due to the slow bureaucratic processes. There are now 707 cases of coronavirus in the country as of Thursday, March 26, with 45 deaths and 28 recoveries. Worldwide, over 18,000 people died, while more than 404,000 people were infected across 196 countries. Student governments of the Ateneo de Manila University, University of the Philippines Diliman, De La Salle University Manila, and University of Santo Tomas urge the Commission on Higher Education to suspend online classes nationwide as the country grapples with a novel coronavirus outbreak. Student groups earlier aired their concerns about transitioning to e-learning in the middle of a pandemic. The students point out access to internet connection and learning devices continued to be a privilege, and those with poor internet access are at a disadvantage when it comes to online classes. They say it is also difficult for students to focus on academic requirements, especially if they are already struggling physically, mentally, and financially. Classes in all levels and government work in Metro Manila are suspended until April 14, as Luzon is in a 30-day lockdown. Anger rises in Taiwan as Chinese fighter jets and warships fly around the island, even as both countries fight the global coronavirus pandemic. Beijing ramped up drills around the island since President Tsai Ing-wen was first elected in 2016 because she refuses to acknowledge its concept that Taiwan is part of one China. Taipei's Defense Ministry said four targeted drills were conducted by China near its borders this year as concrete evidence of provocations and threats. The coronavirus killed more than 3,000 people in China. But despite its close proximity, Taiwan only has 235 cases and 2 deaths. Taiwan is considered a model for outbreak response. Actress Iza Calzado is in the hospital Wednesday, March 25, after being diagnosed with pneumonia. The actress, 37, has also been tested for coronavirus but is still waiting for the test results. She writes on Instagram, "It's been a challenging time for me, but it cannot compare to the frontliners who have cared for me and to whom I am so grateful." Meanwhile, actor Christopher De Leon has been discharged from the hospital after testing positive for coronavirus. On Tuesday, March 24, his wife, actress Sandy Andolong, posted on Instagram stories photos of her husband leaving the hospital. De Leon will still undergo self-quarantine for 14 days.